Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to show you how you can model this object in Blender. So I'm going to start in a new scene. I'm going to add a cylinder. I'm going to set the amount of vertices to 24. There you go. Let me switch to orthographic mode. I'm going to slice this cylinder in half so we can focus only on one side. There we go. And I'm going to add the mirror modifier. Nice. Okay, so now to have that detail on the side, all we need to do is to cut or define where we are going to cut it, and we can do it using the knife tool. So I think about here, I'm going to press X to lock on the Z-axis and confirm it. So this is the region that I'm going to choose. Now we could use E to extrude it down and clean up the mess, but Blender has a nice feature called without E, called Extrude Manifold, that we just need to pull this down like this, and it's already connected, it's clean. Okay, so now that we have this, I'm going to run a loop on the middle and align this region with my loop. To do so, I'm going to use the snap tool, set to vertex, snap with the active point. Now, if I choose this as my active point, press G to move it, Z to lock on the Z axis, and press Ctrl, I can snap to my loop. I'm going to press J to connect them. And there we go. This is the base shape of the detail. And now I'm going to show you two ways that we can accomplish that good-looking smooth shape. Because if we subdivide this right now, it looks like this. So we have to run loops through it, and I'm going to show you how to do it in two different ways. The first one is the quick and dirty. We can select the edges that we want to be sharp. In this case, those edges, and using this mean bevel weight property, I'm going to crank this up until the lines turn blue and add a bevel modifier. Now with the bevel modifier, the default behavior is this, but we can modify this to create supporting edges for us. To do so, we change the limit method to weight, so it will use our blue lines, and in the profile section, the shape we set it to 1, and the amount of segments we set it to 2. Now if I go to wireframe, I can see that it created supporting edges for us, and it looks quite nice. So when I subdivide this, let's see, we have this result. Now it's not too bad on the top, on the bottom, but here this is not good, right? The reason why this is happening is because the loops, let me disable this. The loops are all bunched up here. They are all together here. This is bad for the topology. The loops, they need to run like this. To fix this, we can make this line blue as well. Okay, so now if subdivide this, now we have a better result. However, this is still wrong, and let's see if you can catch the wrong part here. Here you can see some shading artifacts. Whenever this happens, whenever the flow gets cut in a weird way, this indicates that we have overlapping geometry. Now, sometimes Blender has this weird thing that all you have to do is to move this a little bit up or down, and this sort of fix it. So now if I apply this subdivision modifier, we have a much better result. And this is it. This is the quick and dirty way. You can control how sharp those edges are by changing the amount of the bevel. So yeah, this is the quick way to achieve this result. Now the second method requires a bit more planning, so I'm going to keep this to compare the two of them. I'm going to add another cylinder. Let me actually hide this so we don't get destructive. Same procedure, slice the cylinder in half. Add the mirror, like so. Now, let me bring it back. We know that our detail is about this size if you want to do it again. We know that. However, we also know that we need a supporting edge to create this sharp section here. So what we can do is we can plan out our cut. So I'm actually going to cut a little bit over here, a little bit farther from the original point. So about here. Let me pull this here. So this is where I'm going to cut it. And I'm going to use the extrude manifold again with Alt E and pull it down. Now, as I pull down, you can see that I automatically have a supporting edge here. See? So this is going to make our lives much easier. Now, I'm going to do the same thing as I did here. I'm going to hide this, run a loop around, and align this to the loop, connect it with J. Okay, we have that base shape again. And I'm going to start drawing the topology to finish this off. So instead of going like this, adding an insetting to create this, I'm going to use the bevel tool, but instead of the modifier, I'm going to use on the control B on the hotkey. It works the same, it's a bit quicker. Now, this is about the size that I want. I do not need to press control B again. All I need to do is select this and press shift R. It will repeat my last operation. And I can do the same for this part here as well, shift R. There we go. And you can already see how what we are achieving, right? Since we did it this planned way, we are not disturbing the structure of the cylinder, see? Now, this is already looking quite nice. All I need to do is to fix this loop. Let me cut it here and connect this. Make this straight. There we go. The benefit of this, although N-gons are usually not an issue, I used to think that they were bad. Now I don't really think about them that way. But a benefit of this method is that we have an all quads solution. So if it if this does matter to you, this is a good method. Now, if I apply the subdivision again, oops, I forgot a loop here. Let me quickly add here. Now, if we subdivide this, we have, I'm going to bring the other mesh, but we have tiny, super, super tiny amount of artifacts. It's barely noticeable. The reason why is because we have a good amount of vertices. 24 is usually, it is a good amount of vertices for this detail. I've tried with 16. It looks good, but the artifacts is, it is a bit more visible. So the lower you go with your poly count, the more visible the artifacts will be. So this is the comparison between the two. Of course, this one was a lot more quicker to do than this one, but it is up to you to use the technique that you like the most. For me, I personally had when I was practicing this, I had the most fun doing this one. But it is up to you. As long as you get a nice result, that's what matters. So I hope you have enjoyed this. And if you do, and if you did, do not hit the like button. Instead, I would like to see you write a nice comment saying what went well and what could be improved. That way I can make better videos in the future. And as always, thank you for watching.